The question that's generating headlines again, is there a link between taking acetaminophen, also known as Tylenol or paracetamol, during pregnancy and the risk of autism in children? It's a complicated topic. Autism is a multifaceted condition, and while some studies report associations, even the strongest ones show only very small effects. So which conclusions are reasonable and which ones go too far? That's the topic of this week's Healthcare Triage. Autism is complex. There is not a single cause, and it doesn't spring from one exposure or drug. It's widely accepted that many early life factors contribute to neurodevelopment, including family history, genetic variants, prenatal exposures, maternal health, and more. So when we hear claims like Tylenol causes autism, that oversimplifies the science. A more accurate framing is, does prenatal acetaminophen exposure slightly shift risk under certain conditions? And even then we must ask, is that association causal or confounded? But let's back up to the event that caused the most recent headlines. In August of 2025, a high-profile review was published in Environmental Health. The authors conducted what's known as a Navigation Guide Systematic Review, a methodology originally designed for environmental health policy that aims to transparently assess and rate the quality of evidence across studies. The study's authors identified 46 eligible studies linking acetaminophen in pregnancy with neurodevelopmental disorders like autism and ADHD. Out of those, 27 found at least some significant positive association, 9 found no association, and 4 even suggested a protective effect. The authors noted that higher quality studies were more likely to find at least a small positive association, but crucially, they did not claim causation. They cautioned that residual confounding, bias, measurement error, and diverse study designs prevented strong causal claims. In their summary, the authors highlight that even if there is an effect, it would be modest, and they urge more rigorous research. I want to stress that even in the studies reporting a positive association, the effect sizes are tiny, often amounting to a fraction of a percentage point difference. Even if one study suggests a relative risk increase of 5%, in absolute risk terms, that might be 0.09% or so, meaning less than one extra case per thousand. And beyond that, some of the best data we have do not suggest increased risk. For example, a 2024 Swedish study of 2.5 million children initially found a slightly elevated risk, but when they did a sibling control analysis, which helps control for family-related confounds, evidence for the elevated risk disappeared. So what does that mean? It means that the small signal of elevated risk seen before the sibling control analysis was likely due to confounds related to family factors like genetics and/or shared environments. And family confounds aren't the only concern. What if the pregnant person was taking acetaminophen because of fever, infection, or other conditions which can themselves influence neurodevelopment? It could be that the signal of elevated risk is coming from the underlying conditions that prompted the use of acetaminophen, not the drug itself. Other problems that complicate how we interpret these studies include subjects incorrectly remembering or reporting exposures, measurement errors in dosing or timing, and publication bias, which is the issue of positive scientific findings being more likely to be published, which is quite a big problem in science. In short, association does not equal causation, and even a consistent association could have hidden biases. We also can't forget that there's a flip side to this. There is a risk in not taking medication during pregnancy when it's indicated. Untreated fever or pain during pregnancy can result in serious health risks for both mother and baby. Of note, the medical and scientific community has pushed back on oversimplified claims. The American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists called announcements tying Tylenol to autism irresponsible, noting that no reputable study has confirmed a causal link. The Autism Science Foundation also issued statements cautioning against overstated claims. Autism is a complex condition with many contributing factors, and reducing it to a single drug exposure oversimplifies the reality. Hey, did you enjoy this episode? You might enjoy this previous episode on the risks of a federal autism registry. We'd appreciate it if you'd like the video down below, subscribe to the channel, maybe go on over to patreon.com/healthcaretriage, help support the show, make it bigger and better. We'd especially like to thank our research associates, Edward Liljeholm and Joshua Crow, and of course, our surgeon admiral, Sam.